Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to create a symbol palette and add shapes and connectors to it. You will also see how to add descriptions to the symbols and customize them using height, width, and palette expand mode properties. First, I open an existing Blazor application with a Blazor diagram component with height and width properties. If you want to know how to create this Blazor WebAssembly application and add SyncFusion components to it, you can refer to the video attached in the YouTube card above. I run this application to show the initial output. The diagram canvas has been rendered with the defined height and width dimensions. Now, I will show you how to add the Blazor symbol palette component. As a first step, I import the SyncFusion Blazor diagram symbol palette namespace. Then, I add the symbol palette by defining the SF symbol palette component tag and adding the properties height and width. I set the height to 700 pixels and the width to 300 pixels. As I would like to align the symbol palette and diagram components adjacently, I place them inside division elements. And add class attributes to them. Within the style tag, I define those classes and apply the styles margin left and margin top with appropriate values. I reduce the width of the diagram component to 900 pixels. Look here, the symbol palette component has been rendered with no symbols in it. Let's see how to add symbols to the palette. I first create an instance for the class diagram object collection of type palette with a name palettes to hold a collection of palette objects. Next, I am going to add symbols to this palettes object. To do that, I define the method initializePalette. And initialize the instance palettes here. Now, I am going to add basic shapes to the palettes, so I define a method, createBasicNode. Which accepts two parameters, ID and shapes type. Before creating the shape node here, I create an alias for the SyncFusion Blazor diagram node shapes namespace called shapes to avoid importing a whole namespace multiple times while adding the node shapes. Then, within the createBasicNode method, I create a node named newNode. Define the properties ID and set the ID value received in the argument. The shape type is basic. And shape is the type of the shape received here. Then I return this new node. Now, let's see how to add the basic shapes rectangle, triangle, ellipse, diamond, and parallelogram using this createBasicNode method. I create an object, basic shapes of type node base, to hold this collection of shapes. To this basic shapes object, I first add the rectangle shape by calling the create basic node method. By passing the ID rectangle and shape type rectangle. Similarly, I add other basic shapes by calling the same method, create basic node. Now, the basic shapes are added to the basic shapes object. Then, I add this basic shapes object to the palette by creating a new palette object and assigning the ID basic shape, the title basic shapes, basic shapes to the symbols. Then, I override the onInitialized method and make a call to this initializePalette method. Finally, I add this palette's collection to the symbol palette component using the palette's property. You can see the symbol palette is rendered with the basic shapes. Notice that the shapes are rendered in their default dimensions. To customize the height and width of the symbols, you would use the symbol height and symbol width properties. To demonstrate, I set the symbol height property to 70 pixels and the symbol width to 70 pixels. The shapes are rendered in the defined dimensions. Next, I will add flow shapes to the palette. To do that, I create an object called flow shapes of type node base to hold the collection of flow shapes. To this flow shapes object, I add shapes like terminator, process, and display by defining the method createFlowNode. As this method has the same logic as the createBasicNode method, I follow the same code in this method. Next, I add the flow shape, terminator, by calling the createFlowNode method. By passing the ID, terminator, and flow shape type, terminator, as parameters. Similarly, I add other flow shapes by calling the same method. Then, I add this flow shapes object to the palette by creating a new palette object. And assigning flow shapes as the ID. Flow shapes as the title. And flow shapes object to the symbols. The flow shapes panel is added to the palette, and it has defined flow shapes in it. Notice that, when I try to drag and drop the shapes into the diagram canvas, I am not able to. This is because I have not set the target of the symbol palette. I set this diagram component as a target element of the symbol palette by initializing the SF diagram component and SF symbol palette component. I then add a reference to the components using the @ref property with the appropriate values. Then, I override the onAfterRender method Define the target property of the symbol palette. And assign diagram to it. To add the nodes from the symbol palette to the diagram, I create an instance, nodes, of type node. And add this nodes collection to the diagram component using the nodes property. Now, I can drag and drop symbols from the palette to the diagram. I need a connector to connect these nodes. To add connectors to the palette, I create a connectors object of type nodeBase. I am going to add connectors to this object by defining the method createConnector. That receives an ID. The connector segment type. And the decorator shape type as arguments. I create a new connector. And I assign this ID to the ID. Connector segment type to the type. And shape to the target decorator. I also define the source point as 0. And target point as 40. I return the connector. Inside the initializePalette method, I am going to add the connectors, orthogonal and straight, by calling the method createConnector. Then, I will add this connectors object to the palette by creating a new palette object. And assigning connectors to the ID, title, and symbols. You can see the connectors palette was added to the symbol palette component. Next, I will show you how to draw a simple flowchart for adding two numbers by dragging the shapes and connectors to the diagram component. See, this flowchart explains a simple flow for adding two numbers. By default, all the panels are in expand mode. If you want to expand only one panel at a time, you can use the palette expand mode property. To demonstrate, I define the property palette expand mode within the SF symbol palette component tag and set its value to single. See, only one panel is expanded at a time. Here, the symbols are rendered in the palette without any description. To add a description to the symbols, I add the event, getSymbolInfo. With event handler, getSymbolInfo. I define the event, getSymbolInfo, that receives the diagram object argument. Then, I define a string variable, description, and assign the value of the node ID if the node is present. Then, I define the symbolInfo property, description, and assign this description to it. I return this symbolInfo. The symbols are now rendered with the description. In this video, you have seen how to create a symbol palette and add basic shapes, flow shapes, and connectors to it. You have also seen how to add descriptions to the symbols and customize them using symbol height, width, and palette expand mode properties. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, like it and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.